to play some more Yu-Gi-Oh! Legacy of the Duelist. Be on with the Yu-Gi-Oh! Zexo Walker back playing a while ago. I had to do some little videos that I've been like here to just do. But now I'm thinking about it, I should have been doing something like that between these campaigns. So I'll wrap up Zexo's walkthrough. And I will go back to character center videos. Theme decks that I want to do. Get back to this. Leave a like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. Carl on YouTube. And let's get to play. Era. Astro found himself becoming more and more acclimated to this world that he found himself in. Part of that, he became addicted to the enthralling action of the 15 shows are in Dust Valley. Identified with the lead character who was also from Understanding TV, he encouraged Yuma to seek out the Sparrow's help. Yuma was not hearing it. However, the next day at school, his friend brought him. Hey, Yuma! You here? Sparrow's down by the seaport. They built a set down, on L Street. Not squander this opportunity. Sparrow really arrived here through a It wasn't long before they found themselves sneaking onto the mishap. Yuma and his friends were discovered. In the process, Yuma dropped his dual deck. Security guards escorted them out. The Sparrow suddenly descended. Deck yours because I know it isn't mine. That's what I thought to be. Thanks. You don't need to thank me, although I do have a small request. What is it? I would like to challenge you to a lavish duel. Awesome! You like to duel? I'm not saving the universe? Yes. You say we duel right now, Sparrow. You mean it? Great. By the way, my real name is Nelson. Nelson had to duel. Fortunately, Nelson's mother interrupted him. Night, on the deck of his hotel room, Nelson came across a mysterious number card. Alexei. Picked it up, it overcame him, possessing him. It was a Sparrow. Soon, Yuma and Tori heard running amok. Tori grabbed Yuma and ran to the streets. What are we doing out here, Tori? Out here to prove the Sparrow's innocence. Tying random people up and flipping over cars. Sparrow would never do stuff like that. So long before Yuma and Tori came across Nelson, lurking in the streets. Nelson, why are you going around attacking people dressed up like a Sparrow? I have to fulfill my duty to the Galaxy Queen. Or to see the Dark Emperor Furious Max and his queen. Why have you come here? Has the Dark Emperor managed to sink his claws into you as well? Step out of it, Nelson! If I align with the Dark Emperor, then I have no choice but to battle you. If you want the battle, I challenge you to a duel! I don't remember Yuma's deck being. This deck is okay. Sometimes it's like really gotta count on Utopia more often than not to do most of it. Like with Aiden's deck, it's like if you have Jaden's deck and it's just surrounded by you counting on the playing wingman all the time. Is always in the back. I love the cinematic film. Nothing. Well, was just thinking about that magic card. Honestly, I played this character before, against this character before, and it was like a crazy time just trying to beat him. I mean, how many times I've been the character before and lost? Multiple times. I have to use other decks just to get by him. Bro, I won the number 83 Galaxy Queen card. A card and unlock yet another of Astral's Mask. I remember at the moment. Lion Frenzy. One of Yuma's classmates, Kathy Catherine. I think Catherine grew jealous of Special Relationship that created Yuma. It's jealousy that drove her to command her. Friends, you're the only ones that care about me. I need your help. I need you. Annoying little mouse. Mouse has things I don't have. Yes. Friends. Not fair. Makes me a sad kitten. I don't like her, do we? I want you to find this little mouse. When you do, I want you to pounce. I don't know if cats found Tony's mother. Nice, please? Elsewhere, a cat delivered a note to Yuma. Have your friend follow us to get her back. At napping Tori. Who are you? Kathy Catherine. I'm with Tori. Tori. Is she all you think about? No, I think about lots of stuff, but, whatever. Let her go. Only if you defeat me in a duel. Not a scaredy cat, are you? Astro, think she's got a number card? Way. Let's do this. As Kathy is not like one of those memorable characters. Hey, we wonder when Rex Raptor is more memorable than her. More memorable? Laugh. Thank you. Worry about her face down the cards, but some of this card by using. The other one would have been useful, at least less life points. Thank you. Another strong monster to play. Only another monster. You can add her life points. I know I complain about this deck being so centered around Utopia, but let's be honest, like, no different when Zane has this Cyber End Dragon. The support cards is one hell of a thing. Thank you. How the world fighter of Balmon or some beast cat. A while ago. This deck is not really my go-to kind of deck. I think it's about it, but honestly, I have more fun with like maybe like Jaden and Yuki deck. You say it's dead. Often than not. Magikarp is so annoying. Ow, Utopia. More Utopia monsters. Utopia Ray V. Utopia Ray Victory. Declares an attack on a place of monster. Fetch one hit. Yeah. There we go. Third try. Does not possess a number card. Feels a deal. This is the part where you tell me where Tori is, cat. Alright, Yuma. Yuma found Tori, she was just. Wanted me to play with them and they were so cute. I refuse. I just lost her. People always seem to follow Yuma, and always seem to revolve around the number card. Right, suddenly appeared out of nowhere. He was a number hunter. Right, immediately activated a dual field that was when people with numbers. I know you have a number. Run out, you're stuck in this. I will do for numbers. Well, get set to get decked. You're going down, number hunter. We are about to have is not for fun. Meanwhile, a man named Dr. Fecker. Meanwhile, a man named Dr. Fecker, Kite's brother Hart's life energy to attack the astral world. However, Kite was unaware of Dr. Fecker. Oh, working! The energy is flowing! Well done, Hart. Astral world, pay. Make them pay with your power. Brother! The message, Master Kite. It's in trouble. This is late. Now I must leave. Oh. Now they choose a different deck. This one is hard. After his battle with Kite, Yuma defeated him. Personally, a monster appeared from the card and attacked Astro. Let's give you two. Rock. Why? Just do it. Rock, catch. Got it. Hey, tall, dark, and creepy. You want this number so bad? Beat me in a duel. Huh? No, Brock. Just run. Forgive me and save yourself. Go away, Yuma. I'd never leave a friend behind.
How touching. Very well. Let us duel.
Big bags, I usually go with my Exodia deck because they're no joke. The last match for the video, but let's make it very enticing. I like doing villains' voices for some reason. Darkness. You Honestly, don't care if I summon Exodia, but just get past the deal. Almost there. One or the other, I'm winning this duel. I honestly gotta say, I remember this episode. Dark Astro was fascinating. We loved that episode. So, Bronk is more of a Link character than Tori. more cards. No way! I lost possible. Hit it wrong. Thanks, pal. The defeat of number 96, Dark Mist, Astro absorbed him back into himself. It was over for now. Okay. That was a nice long video. Thank y'all for joining me. Time we act will be Love Hurts and going through. At least my next video will be using Kite's deck, which is pretty good. Another run of mill Seto Kaiba clone, technically, but. Probably gonna be using Kite at least a couple of times next week. I'll see y'all next time. Thank you all for joining me. Once again, leave a like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff to Talking of Carl on YouTube, Twitch, and Instagram. Until next time for more Yu-Gi-Oh! Thank you.